In this Calculus 3 tutorial, let's talk about how we can evaluate line integrals by using the definition and parametrization of the curve. For the first one, we have the integral over c, we have 2 plus x squared y ds. Here, c is the upper half of x squared plus y squared equals 1. So notice this is just a unit circle and we want the upper half of it. So let's take a look at the picture real quick. So we want this right here to be our c. So this is 1 and this is negative 1, of course. Now, we need a parametrization for this. And to do so, we can just use sine cosine. Take x to be cosine t and then y to be sine t. Just like the good old days. X is the cosine, y will give you the sine. Now, we are going from here to here. So we can take this angle, right? That's when t is equal to 0. And then we just have to rotate up to there, and that will be when t is equal to pi. So that's it, and then we are going in this direction. Now, we are going to take this integral to the t world. So, this right here becomes integral going from t equals 0 to pi. And then right here, we will have 2 plus x is cosine t. So let's just write that down. And then we have the squared. Y is sine t. Now, for the ds, this right here is just a small change in the arc length. So just like the good old Cal 2 days, we will open a big square root, and then we are going to square, and then add the other square. Inside here, we are going to differentiate the x equation and also the y equation with respect to t. So if we take the derivative of cosine t, we get negative sine t. And if we take the derivative of sine t, we get cosine t, and then dt, just like that. All right, now we can just take care of this integral like the good old Cal 1 days. So this right here becomes the integral going from 0 to pi. We have 2 plus cosine squared t times sine t. And this right here is actually really nice, because this is just sine squared plus cosine squared, which is just equal to 1. Square root of 1 is of course just equal to 1. And then we have dt. Now, we can break this apart. We can just focus on integrating the 2. And then add it with the integral from 0 to pi of the rest. For this right here, once we integrate it, we get 2t, plugging pi, plugging 0 and subtract. We will end up with 2 pi. Now for this right here, we will just do a use up real quick on the side. So I'm going to say that u equal to cosine t, differentiate that, we get negative sine t dt. Now this right here is positive sine t, so when you plug in, the result will be negative. Let me write that down for you guys real quick. This part, right, just this part, will give us integral. Plugging 0 into t, cosine 0 is equal to 1, so u will start at 1 right here. And then plugging pi in here, cosine pi is equal to negative 1, so u will be negative 1 right here. And this right here is our u, so we have u squared. And again, this right here is going to be negative du. Now, we can use this negative. We can use this negative to change the order of the integration. So this negative can bring, just change it. So we get positive integral, but it will go from negative 1 to 1. And then it's just u squared du. Now this is 1 third u to the third power. And then just plugging. In fact, you can also use the integral property. You can double it and then integrate from 0 to 1. Doesn't really matter in my opinion. That's 1 third minus negative 1 third, we get 2 third for that, right? So all this part is just going to be plus 2 third. And that will do it. Yeah, just like that. Now for the next one, we have a 3D version. We have this integral and we know c is the curve given by this vector function over this time interval. So we pretty much have the parametrization already, which is very nice. So here we go. Take this to the t world. T will go from 0 to 2. So we have 0 and then 2. Now be careful. What's x? Well, you have to look here because this is the x component. So you just have to put t for the x. So we have t plus 2. Then for the ds, well, I'm just going to set it out right here for you guys. We are going to open the square root, and then we are just going to differentiate each component, and then make sure we square each of them, and then we add them up, draw them inside, right? That's our length, pretty much. So differentiating this, we get 1, and then we square that, and then we differentiate this, put the 3 half to the front, 3 and 3 cancel, 2 and 4 cancel, so it's going to be 2t, and then minus 1 half to the power, so that's 1 half power here, and then square that, and then put the 2 to the front, they cancel, we just have t to the first power, and then square that, dt, just like that. Now, it becomes the Calcul question. So this right here is the integral 0 to 2, t plus 2 square root. Okay, what can we do? This is 1 plus, this is 4, and then multiply the power, so it's t, and then this is plus t square dt. Okay, how can we integrate this? Well, in fact, we can just do a u sub, which is quite nice. Put u to be the inside, 1 plus 4t plus t square. Because you will see, after we differentiate this, we get 4 plus 2t dt. And then we can factor out a 2. So this right here is just, let me do it like this. I will factor out 2 and then divide this to the other side. Dt equals du over this thing after we factor out the 2. So put a 2 in front, and then we will have t right here, and then that will be a 2. Yeah, so you see this, and that can cancel. And perhaps that's also take these numbers to the u world. So this is integral. Put 0 into here, u will start at 1. So u starts at 1. Put 2 in here, 2 squared is 4 plus 8, so that's 12, plus 1 more is 13. So u will go to 13. And then let me show you guys a cancellation. This is t plus 2, and then this whole thing inside is just the u. And then dt is that, which is du over 2 times t plus 2. And we see the t plus 2 cancel. Now, put the 1 half to the front, and then rewrite this as the 1 half power. So we are looking at 1 half times the integral going from 1 to 13, u to the 1 half power in the u world. To integrate this, just add 1 to the power, which will give us 3 over 2, divided by the new power, which is multiplied by its reciprocal, so that's 2 over 3. So now, notice the 2 and 2 cancel, we have 1 third like this, and then we are looking at u to the 3 over 2 power, and then we have to draw in numbers. Plugging 13, plugging 1, subtract. So we are going to get 1 over 3 times 13 raised to the 3 over 2 power, and then minus plugging 1. 1 to the 3 over 2 is just 1, so it doesn't really matter. We'll just write it as 1 over 3. And for this right here, you can simplify a little bit, but of course you can also leave it like this. I don't think it matters that much. But if you want to simplify this, I will show you. This right here, it's the same as saying 13 to the 2 over 2 times 13 to the 1 half. And this right here is just 13. So this is 13 times 1 over 3. You have 13 over 3. And then we have the 13 to the 1 half. So you can write it as square root of 13. And then lastly, minus 1 over 3. Yeah, that'll do it. Now for the third one, we have another 3D case. That's the integral. And then right here, we know C is the line segment going from the origin to 1, 2, 1. So let's go ahead and parametrize this real quick. and it's just a line segment, so we can just do this the following way. Notice this is just 1, 2, 1. So we can take x to be 1t, and then y to be 2t, and then z to be 1t, like this. And then we can just say t goes from 0 to 1, and that works wonders. Now, go ahead, take that integral to the t world. Here we will have the integral going from 0 to 1. Okay, x is t, so we will have t squared, and then minus y, which is 2t, so let's put that down, and then plus 3, z is t. So that's what we have. And now for the ds, let's go ahead, open the square root, differentiate it, square that. So we get 1 squared plus differentiate this, square that. So it's 2 squared. And then do it again. Differentiate that, square. Like that. And then we have dt. So this is quite nice because it's just a number. And that's just 1 plus 4 plus 1, which is 6, instead of the square root. Square root of 6. We can put that on the very outside. So we have square root of 6 times the integral from 0 to 1, and then we just have t squared minus 2t plus 3t dt. And now we can just integrate this by using the power rule, which is very nice. So square root of 6, integrating this, we get 1 third t to the third power. Integrating this, I want to the power get 2. Divided by 2, they cancel, so it's minus t squared. Oh, I could have combined them. Actually, let me combine them first. This and that will just get plus t. That's even shorter. Very nice. All right, integrating this, we just get 1 half t squared. And then plugging 1, plugging 0, and then subtract. Plugging 1, this and that will just be 1. So we will first get square root of 6 times 1 third plus 1 half. Plugging 0, both of them will be 0, so it's minus 0, which doesn't matter. Now just clean this up. This is going to be, no, just write it down here. Square root of 6, get the common denominator, all the things. You will get 6 on the bottom and 5 on the top. You can leave it like this. 5 square root of 6 over 6. And if you want to rationalize the numerator, you can actually end up with 5 over square root of 6. Up to you, whichever way that you would like. So that's it. Hopefully this video helps.